Greetings, members one and all of the Salivation Nation. There's an interesting story from the Kitco News about the latest report from the Silver Institute and how green technologies will require the use of more silver. Quite interesting indeed. So-called green technologies meant to better protect the environment while meeting the demands of consumers should boost silver demand in the future, says a report from the Silver Institute. In particular, the report cited an expectation for exponential growth of new energy vehicles, otherwise known as NEVs, and continued investment in solar photovoltaic energy. The combined demand from these two sources will exceed 1.5 million ounces by 2030, the report estimated. The Silver Institute is an industry association based in Washington, D.C., with members consisting of silver producers, refiners, manufacturers, and dealers. The report, titled The Role of Silver in the Green Revolution, was prepared for the Institute by CRU, a commodities consultancy. The report pointed out that the cost of solar photovoltaic systems has fallen rapidly relative to other electrical sources over the past two decades. Silver is used to conduct electricity. It is actually the most conductive of all the elements in the periodic table. This is expected to continue over the medium term, leading to an ever-increasing share of renewable energy generation and investments for PV, led by both macroeconomic cost considerations and public policy, the Silver Institute said. The report estimated that roughly some 820 million ounces of silver will be used by global solar energy applications through 2030. Quite interesting indeed. It'll be interesting to see how that demand compares with prior demand and total silver consumption over the past 10 years. Meanwhile, in an attempt to curb pollution, many governments have provided financial incentives and passes new regulations favoring the development of electrical and hybrid vehicles, the Silver Institute said. And also here in the United States, there was a 30% tax incentive for solar panels purchased through 2016. A potential game changer for the transportation is the use of inductivity-coupled power transfer technology to wirelessly charge vehicles using silver-plated induction coils. Quite fascinating indeed. Though current market penetration remains low, improvements in performance and cost can open significant opportunities for wireless charger adoption in the coming years. And that is one of the things that electric vehicles, that is one of the things that is inhibited that technology is charging of the batteries, because it takes hours to do mostly. But if you can find ways to be able to charge your vehicles while you're in shopping or whatever, perhaps it could be much more viable if they can make that technology work. These efforts are forecast to require approximately 725 million ounces of silver through 2030, the report said. Further, the Silver Institute pointed out that silver is used in the generation of nuclear energy. Silver is used with other metals to produce the reactor's control rods. One of the most common materials used is an alloy that is 80% silver, 15% indium, and 5% cadmium. Though small in terms of the expected offtake at 19 million ounces of total silver demand through 2030, demand for silver in this area could rise with future growth of nuclear reactors globally, the Silver Institute said. So it looks like, especially if we see the economy to continue to improve, that silver will become the forefront in the use of these technologies, and demand for it will increase, potentially causing the price to go up in the future as demand rises. However, as we all know, silver is manipulated, and that manipulation of silver will continue, especially as it's being used for these technologies, especially considering in the the photovoltaic world and solar energy, silver had really come down in price, silver has come down in price too, but the actual installation and the solar panels themselves have come down in price significantly. So we shall see. But in my mind, I could see this news meaning that silver is going to potentially rise, at least to some level, in the coming years, as some believe that we have, if not past peak production with silver, we've come close to peak production. And that means that with demand rising, there's only so much manipulators can do to keep the price down. As I've mentioned in the past, I believe that we'll see silver go up before the end of the year by some measure. What that measure is I believe it'll be just under $20 an ounce, but it could be a little bit less than that. We shall see. Anyways, very exciting indeed to see silver being used in these ways. It is a unique metal. There has been talk, and some of you have heard me mention in a prior video of this nature, that if the price of silver does go up, that they may possibly be using aluminum as a replacement. But there is no real substitute in my mind, because it is the best conductor of electricity. And we also have heard of graphene possibly being used, or graphene, as some pronounce it. But I don't think we're quite there yet to be able to produce graphene on a wide scale. So post your thoughts below on what you think this means for silver. Like to extend a multitude of gratitude to y'all for watching, and encourage you to please rate, comment, and subscribe.